Today, I'll show you how to customize your WooCommerce checkout page for higher conversions and increased sales. Plus, stick around to the end and I'll share 3 tips to help you reduce checkout page abandonment on your WordPress website. So let's dive in. You want to already have WooCommerce installed and set up, and then we're going to install a plugin. The plugin we're going to install is called SeepProd. With SeepProd, you can do several things. You can create landing pages specific for any type of product or service that you have. You can set it up to really do your whole theme. But the reason why we're using it is because it does a fantastic job of customizing any of the WooCommerce areas. Things like your cart area, your cart page, or your checkout page. You can also customize your product pages as well. You can get started with SeepProd's free version, but to show you all the features and for the integration into WooCommerce, I'll be using their pro version. So once you set up an account and you can log in, you can download the plugin to your computer. While we're here, let's go ahead and also copy our license key. And then we'll head back over to our dashboard. We'll come over to plugins, add new, and we want to install the plugin. You can either choose file and find it on your desktop or have it right here. So I'm going to just left click, drag it up. We'll click install now. And I'll clean up a little bit. Once installed, you want to activate the plugin as well. From here, you can enter your license key that we copied. And let's go ahead and verify the key. We should get a green check mark that we have a valid license key. And now we can make the changes that we want. So over on the left, let's come over to landing pages because we're creating a completely new checkout landing page. Effectively, it is a landing page. And so let's click on add new. And from here, you have all of these templates that you can choose from. So you don't have to start from scratch. You can simply choose one and save some time. But to show you just how easy it is, I will actually use a blank template to set this up. You want to give it a page name. And you notice when you give it a page name, it also gives you the URL or the web address for this. And now we can save and start editing the page. From here, we want to start adding the bits of our site. So I'm going to come up here under sections. I want to add the header section. So I'm going to click on header. And you can choose from any of these headers that you want. I'm going to choose the header one to add, and it drops it down here. Now you can change out your logo. So if I click on here, over on the left, I can either delete it, add a new one. If you don't have a logo, you could also use a stock image. All image insertions include millions of stock images. That would be perfect for somewhere else on the page. For this, we'll just use our logo. So I'm going to go use your own image. If you have it in the media library, then you can use that here. Or I also have one, so I'm going to select it. Looks pretty good. And then you can also choose how you want your menu structure. If you have a checkout page, you don't want them to go anywhere else. So we're going to actually remove all of the menu items. Let's go ahead and delete that, but we'll leave that space here. And then under call to action, I'm going to change this. So I'm going to click on the button and I'm going to say view cart. And then we're going to link that to our cart page. You can also choose to open in a new window or add no follow if you want. For this, we don't need that because we want to keep them on our page and they're on our site. So we don't need to say no follow. You can also choose the size of the button here. We'll keep it at medium. So all of that looks good for this. Okay, now I want to have this above my layout. So I'm actually going to highlight this whole area until I see purple. And I'm just going to click it and move it up because I want that at the top. So now we can choose our layout. And for this, I want a layout where I have most of the content on the left and I want like a little sidebar on the right. So we'll do that one and we see these items here. So the cool thing is now we can come up here to the blocks. We scroll all the way down. We have our standard blocks, which are all of these great items that we can add: button, header, divider, text. You can do advanced. So you can do a giveaway if you want somewhere on your site with this as well. Scrolling all the way down, though, we now have WooCommerce section. So you have add to cart, you have your checkout, you have products, as well as best or recent products as well. So what we want to do on the left is we want to bring the checkout page. So it'll automatically come in and bring this in so you can see what it looks like. And then on the right, I want to bring some more items in. So I want to scroll all the way down again. I want to go to best products or best selling products. You could also do a featured product if you're really wanting to sell a particular one. And this will bring this in. From here, when we click on it, we can adjust it. So we just want one column. And you can do pagination. And we just want to show one. Which looks good, but I also want to give it a title, basically. So I want to give it a headline. So I'm going to bring it headline over here and just say best selling to really encourage them to buy. But maybe I want to add a little more. So I'm going to come back over here and we're also going to add a few other items. For this, I also want to add a testimonial. So you can either scroll through and look at them, but if you want to, you can also search if you know the name of the block. So I'm going to left click and drag this. And put testimonial underneath. You can click on it and choose how you want it to look. We're happy with that. One more thing that I want to do is a ratings. I want to do a star ratings. So I'm going to type in star. We'll bring the star ratings over. And that looks really good. So already I really like the look of this. It's what I want for my new cart. So I'm happy with that. You can continue to customize and make any changes that you want, and this will be your checkout page, your new custom checkout page. So we're happy with this. I'm going to go ahead and click Save Changes. And we also want to come over to the dropdown, and we're going to publish this. And then we can see it live on the site. And this is what it looks like. Really good setup, and I'm really happy with it. And then the cool thing about this is you can also track the conversion. You can watch a video that I'll have in the description below where I cover how to track your WooCommerce conversion. And then that way you can see, is this performing better or was your previous version better? You can track that. Just check out the link in the description below. The other thing we need to do is we need to come back. We'll close this out and we want to assign that page to WooCommerce. So let's exit out of here. By default, WooCommerce has all of their pages already set up. So we'll go to WooCommerce. Let's go to settings. You need to go to advanced. And you see the checkout page is checkout ID. By default, we called it checkout page. Yours might be different. Just know, remember what the page name is. And when I assign it to that now, anytime I go to the checkout page, that will be the one that is served. And then if you want to customize even more, you can also customize your cart page. I did a whole video on that. You can check that out as well. I'll share it in the end of the video on just how to customize that. And between the two of those, you should be able to increase the conversion rate on your site. But let me share three tips on how to reduce cart abandonment on your site. Tip number one is to reduce any add-on checkout charges. So if you're adding something like, say, your shipping, or if there's taxes that you have to collect, that's understandable, but don't hide them to the very end. Either show them right up front so that they know that there's a charge, or in terms of like shipping, add that into the total cost of the website or the total cost of the product. That way they don't feel like they're having to add more to it. That's why a lot of companies, the product itself might cost a little bit more or look like it costs a little bit more, but that's because the shipping is already offered in as free shipping. Tip number two is to make account creation simpler. So when you require registration, when they just want to check out what they put in their cart, then there's going to be a lot of friction. If you can allow your users to either not create an account or make it a requirement, instead set up a registration form to grow your email list. You also want to consider simplifying or reducing the number of required fields during the checkout page. They feel like they have to fill out so much more. Like if it's a digital product and you're requiring shipping address, then that's a lot of friction that isn't needed. So the goal is to simplify and eliminate any fields that aren't needed on the checkout page. And tip number three is just to offer more checkout payment options. If somebody sees the payments that are available, but they don't see the one that they prefer, then that also might cause cart abandonment. So see if you can offer as many payment options as possible. And now if you want to do the double whammy of setting up your cart and customizing your cart page, watch this video next as I walk you through step by step on how to customize your WooCommerce cart as well. And I'll see you over there.